let's study reflection and transmission of waves. Let's discuss if there is a boundary of two media, medium 1 and medium 2, where the wave can propagate with the speed v1 and a speed v2, and corresponding to the speed, so wave number can also be defined. Say from medium 1, a wave incident onto the boundary of the two media, which is called incident wave. And say the incident wave is having an amplitude A, and its displacement of medium particles can be given as yi. After incident, when the medium boundary oscillates, it will spread out waves in both the directions, and the wave which is bounced back, a part of wave which is bound back into the same medium is called reflected wave, having displacement medium particle represented by the term yr. Say it is the reflected wave, which is of amplitude say ar, and this is the transmitted wave, which is considered to be of amplitude at. In this situation, the medium particle displacement due to transmitted wave is given by yt. So here we can say, when the wave is reflected and transmitted into the other media, we can say the medium particles which are in medium 1 will oscillate in the influence of both incident wave and reflected wave, whereas the medium particle in the other medium will oscillate only in the influence of transmitted waves. Here the amplitude of reflected and transmitted waves are given by the respective coefficients of reflection and transmission, as we can write here amplitude of reflected and transmitted waves are given as, we can write AR is small AR into A, and amplitude of transmitted wave can be written as AT into A, where AR and AT are the coefficient of reflection and transmission, coefficients of reflection and transmission for the respective amplitudes. Let's analyze the situation of reflection and transmission of waves mathematically. Say in medium 1, as the wave speed is v1, the angular wave number can be written as omega by v1, and in medium 2, the angular wave number can be written as omega by v2. As we already studied that during any wave phenomena, frequency never changes. So here, if incident wave is given as A sine of omega t minus k1x, as the wave is traveling in positive direction of x-axis, correspondingly we can write down the equations of reflected and transmitted wave here. Like here, reflected wave equation we can write as AR, which is the reflection amplitude, sine of omega t plus k1x. And for transmitted wave, we can write yt is equals to at, which is the amplitude of transmitted wave, sine of omega t minus k2x. As the medium is changed, angular wave number will also change. Now we can talk about the particles which exist on the boundary. If we just have a look on these particles, boundary particles from the side of medium 2, these appear to oscillate in the influence of only transmitted wave. And if we see the particles which are at x equals to 0, that is on boundary from the side of medium 1, these will oscillate in the influence of both incident and reflected waves. So we can say for boundary particles at x equals to 0, we have yi plus yr should be equals to yt, because the displacement of one particle must remain same whether we see it from this side or we see it from this side. And if we substitute the values here at x equals to 0, all terms gets cancelled out and we'll be getting a plus ar is equals to at. Along with this, if the displacement curve is plotted, we can see the slope of displacement curve from left side as well as on the right side must remain same. So here we can see finding slope of displacement curve of boundary particles, we get from left hand side it is del y by del x plus del y, this del y I by del x, del y r by del x is equals to del y t by del x. From right side it is under the influence of y t and on left side it is due to both. So if we substitute the partial derivatives at x equals to 0 for these, the equations will be having, if we differentiate it, it will be minus a k1 cos of omega t plus ar k1 cos of omega t is equals to minus a t k2 cos of omega t. Here this cos omega t also gets cancelled out and we are getting a relation a minus ar is equals to a t into k2 by k1. So this is our equation 1 and this is our equation 2. And on solving these equations, we can easily get the values of ar and at. So here we can write from 1 and 2. You can see if we add these two equations, we'll be getting on left hand side, it will be 2a is equals to at 1 plus k2 by k1. This will give us the value of transmission amplitude, which can be given as the amplitude of transmitted wave. This can be written as 2k1 upon k1 plus k2 into a. Or this can also be written as, if we substitute k as omega by v1, k1 as omega by v1 and k2 as omega by v2, this will be given as 2v2 upon v1 plus v2 into a. So this factor 2v2 upon v1 plus v2 and 2k1 upon k1 plus a2 can be written as our transmission coefficient. So your transmission coefficient can be given as 2v2 upon v1 plus v2. If v1 and v2 are the speeds of the wave in medium 1 and medium 2 respectively, this will give us the transmission coefficient. Similarly, we can easily calculate the reflection coefficient also. Similar to that, now we can write from equation 1, AR can be written as AT minus A. When we substitute the value of AT here, we get AR is equals to K1 minus K2 upon k1 plus k2 into a. If we substitute k1 and k2 as omega by v1 and omega by v2, this will give us v2 minus v1 upon v1 plus v2 multiplied by a. Here this constant factor we can write as a reflection coefficient. A reflection coefficient for this boundary for respective amplitude can be given as AR is equals to V2 minus V1 upon V1 plus V2. So this also you should keep in mind. And these transmission and reflection coefficients are directly used to calculate the amplitude of transmitted and reflected waves. Once again we can write amplitude of reflected wave can be written as reflection coefficient multiplied by amplitude of incident wave, an amplitude of transmitted wave is transmission coefficient multiplied by amplitude of incident wave. This is the way how we find out the amplitudes of reflected and transmitted waves.